今天主人公现在正在海里面。今天我们在美国佛罗里达中部的海滨城市 New Smyrna Beach， 这里是全球可能排名第6的最适合冲浪的一个海滩。但你可能从来都没有听过，因为这边真的太小了，常住人口的话可能只有1-2万人。我们今天主人公很有趣，
他们是在美国的一对网红小夫妻，老公是职业冲浪选手加旅游博主，老婆是当地小有名气的厨师和美食博主。我们会和他们过一天，聊聊在美国做一个斜杠青年和网红到底是一种什么样子的体验。
So I wake up, I walk the dog, he waits the sunstarts about peeking out to rise, and then I go check the waves, maybe pop a couple of sunrise photos, post a couple of shots.
The reason why I'm here, my dad came here because of the waves and this, the great culture.
So you're a second generation surfer?
Yeah, yeah.
About 8 years old is when I started competing. Then about 16 years old is when I was a professional surfer at one point. So I got a silver medal in the ISA World Championships.
Oh my god, that's for me?
Yeah.
Yay!
现在他把我们的冲浪板带出来了。
All right.
The ideal conditions for New Smyrna is like a straight east swell, which is coming straight out of the Atlantic Ocean east into our shore, and lighter winds. The waves, you don't want to be too big in New Smyrna because that means you'll have to like go somewhere else.
Surfing is like definitely a youthful sport. I think competing, you definitely.Retire at a younger age. You can do free surfing, which is a whole other outlet now for surfers since social media came around. You can, you know, link up with a photographer, go on the beach somewhere at a cool location and get photos and literally start creating content for yourself.
社交媒体的出现给 Jeremy 的退役生活带来了新的机遇。他目前运营的2个日更账号吸引了约40,000的粉丝。分别发布 New Smyrna Beach 的海岸风光和自己的冲浪生活记录。
Yeah, this one was taken today while we were shooting.
And you already got liked by like 600 people.
Yeah, in a couple hours.
Couple hours, yeah, that's cool.
Jeremy 告诉我，他的粉丝增长主要依靠风格统一的照片取材和 hashtag 标签功能的运用，这样可以在优质内容的基础上为自己赢得更多曝光和流量的机会。
准备和我们的主人公一起去冲浪，这是我第一次冲浪，我刚去试了一下水温，估计在10度左右吧。哎，我的脚，我的天哪，哎呦，就好了。
学习冲浪的第一步是确定好前后脚。
That's a no.
Yeah.
Then I do this because I'm a right-hander.
Sick. She already knows.
第二步。冲浪板的站姿。
So you see how my like legs are like just kind of slip back, but my front body is like over the board like here. You're kind of like shifting the weight back and forth.
Okay.
第三步也是最难的，起身。
Really naturally, slowly, not really quick at all. Put this foot up first. You can hold onto the rails, push off like that. Keep your feet always together, you know.Like when you try to stand up, so you're gonna want to lift.
Oh, I'm gonna lift.
Boom, just like that. But turn this foot that way.
Oh, I see. And then you just stand up.
Yeah.
第四步下水。
Yo. Really relaxed. The more relaxed, the less you think about it.
Yeah.
Try again. One more time.
You got it. You got it. You got it.
Oh, good. Make sure you're in the middle too. Because if your foot's off the rail, you're gonna.
I'm gonna fall.
Yeah. Try it again, try it again.
Wow. 真的好累，我现在浑身酸痛。
At beginning. It was more just a fun promoting our local surfing vibe and surfers around here. And then it just kind of blew up to where we created photographers and people's career off.
社交网络的人气给 Jeremy 带来了更多，比如原始广告植入，或者是直接个人代言的收入方式。他告诉我，像这样作为博主外拍一天的出场费用，大概是在$350左右。
I just think it's about what makes me happy. Like right now, I'm happy going to the surf shop, and I'm happy running my handles on the side. I think I'm pretty happy with what I'm doing right now, and it really keeps my lifestyle healthy.
Our little pretty house.
Hey!
Hey! Oh, Yodi. Oh.
Like this, more like flat.
I'm Mackenzie Smith, a blogger and chef from New Smyrna Beach, Florida.
Mackenzie 在佛罗里达州长大，在美国的北上广纽约读书工作多年之后，回到了自己出生的小镇，在这里的一家精品酒店担任主厨。同时，他也是当地颇有名气的一个美食博主。
My mom's brother, who was the chef at my family's hotel,He got sick and I came down to help out. But then I met Jeremy. Jeremy like asked me to be his girlfriend and kind of treated me differently than all the guys in New York had. So I was like, yeah, I'll give this a try. So this is our living room. And I have like a mix of like modern and vintage stuff as you can see. So this is our bedroom. Come on, Vinny, get up to your bed.
You wanna go up?
Elo, get up on the bed.
Wow, they're so quick.
This is the second bedroom. Jeremy as a kid.
Oh my goodness. Like how old was he?
I think he was probably like 14.
He told me he was like top two.
Yeah, in the world.
In the world.
Crazy. Thinking about ever leaving New York was terrifying, right?
Yeah.
I thought I was gonna be bored. I didn't think there would be enough opportunities. I thought I would just like regret it.And then this is our little porch.
Mackenzie 他因为自己是一个厨师，所以他自己在后院里面有种很多很多的香草。
So back here is rosemary, and that is dill. And then we've got some mint here, which Elo's like little lizard kingdom. Thai basil.
But do you cook with them too?
Yeah, it smells so good. But this used to be a garage that the people like turned the house into. So now I just use it as like an office and.And then I moved down here and life was so convenient. Mm-hmm. We were able to save money, which I never was able to do in a big city. Yeah. We ended up buying a house on the beach. Our whole entire mortgage is less money than my rent was in New York.
和中国一样，美国一线城市的房价和三四线比起来有巨大的差距。在 Mackenzie 曾经居住的纽约，一套普通三居室公寓，一个月的平均房租是$6,000。而在佛罗里达的这个小镇 ，Mackenzie 一套海景三房也不过$33,000，折合人民币230万。首付两成之后，月供不到$15,000。
Change it up, just have two different looks. Let's do that. Yeah, we'll do pasta. Then we have one of everything. The first reason that people come to New Smyrna are the beaches. The second reason they come is for the food.
There you go.
Crazy.
All in the family.
Yeah, keep it in the family.
Yeah.
Yum.
Classic.
Oh my god. The joke is that we always eat cold food as food bloggers.
Yeah, that's how I would imagine. He is good.
He's good.
作为美食博主 ，Mackenzie 运营三个社交媒体账号加一个博客网站 Grill Cheese Social， 全网70,000粉丝，内容主要集中在美食旅行日记和食谱。
I was really poor in New York, so I was living off of like grilled cheese sandwiches. I was like, what can I write about each week that's affordable, that's easy enough, that won't take enough time away from school? And I was like, grilled cheese, like I can always come up with a really cool grilled cheese sandwich. When you're pulling the noodles up, that's just a,
what are the,
we call it like Instagram gold.
With this or with this?
With that.
With that, okay.
And then just pull the noodles up,
okay.
And hold it still.Pretty color, especially like we use Visco to filter. F2.
和我们这个不火的频道一样 ，Mackenzie 刚开始的时候也是不温不火，直到这个爆款帖子的出现。烤芝士面包这个美国经典的懒人垃圾食品被放在一个横卧的吐司炉中拍下来上传，这瞬间成为了一个被病毒传播的梗。
The only person that read my blog for the first 6 months was my mom.
Yeah.
And then. Pinterest happened, Twitter got big, Facebook got big, and you could start having brand pages on Facebook. So I just started that, and then it was like 1 share, 2 share, 3 share, 4 share, 100 shares, and then
有了一个爆款内容，加上后续有意识的从不同平台引流 ，McKinsey 的博主之路也开始风生水起。
So do you ever think about maybe just one day work together and just build something much bigger?
Yes, absolutely. I think like the end goal is to definitely be like our own brand together. I guess it would kind of depend on like where the future takes us. But right now we both got a thing where my followers know who he is and his followers know who I am.So it's definitely this mutual relationship that's like evident, even though it's not under one brand name. But like when a travel tourism board invites me to come, they know Jeremy's coming too. And that's pretty cool.
说这个地方，你感觉说好像所有的东西都很平静，也没有太多事情发生，每天就是重复的可能到 beach， 然后可能是在自己的 surf shop work。但是因为社交网络的发展和社交网络的发达，他们有办法通过社交网络给自己重新又找到了另外一个事业的突破口，所以哪怕是回到了小镇，生活也是一样丰富多彩，甚至他们在用自己在社交网络媒体上的影响力重新带动这个小镇它新的一轮的复苏跟复兴。